So here's the Corsica with the Corsican head. And there was a Corsican guy, he, you know, I was filming for the nationalist movement in Corsica, the FLNC. And he explained me the Negro head here. Why? Because the Corsicans are white people. Well, you know, the Arabs, they were launching, long before the Crusades happened, they were launching attacks on the European continent, stealing the women, you know. And but of course there was the aristocracy, you know, the caliph and the emir, as they did in Europe, you know, they used primi noctis. So, but the Corsican, they took hold of a lot of Corsican women, the men, what they were working. And so this Corsican warrior chief, he said, you're gonna regret this, because it was my woman and I love her. And so he took a lot of guys together and with a couple of Corsican ships, and he went to Arabia, and there was a fight with the caliph, and he came back with the caliph's head, this one here, of the Moors, and with his wife. And he said, well, I got her back. So from then on, they had the Negro head of the caliph of the Moors, and which became the symbol of the Corsican liberation front and of the Corsican flag. Beautiful story, actually. So, you know, long before the Crusades, you know, the Arabs, they launched attacks on the shore of Europe, stealing women. And in 732, I think it was, there was the Battle of Poitiers. They went all the way up to the north of France almost, and you know, aggressing the Europeans. So this is a beautiful story. And actually, in Corsica, is the only place in France where there's no rape. A Corsican will never rape a woman. He'll never do this. It's, you know, out of the question. Beautiful story. Ah, look at that. They made the straws like in a Templar's cross. Well, what do you know, eh?